Welcome back. My name is Atisha, lecturer from Praveen Patil College of Diploma Engineering and Technology. Today we will see the last practical of mobile application development, that is practical number 31 and 32. And the program is deploy map based application, which is related with the Google Map. Now the exercise is write a program to locate a user's current location. So we need to write a program by using a Google Map. We will locate where the user is currently located. User's current location, we need to find out. So for that, first of all, the procedure is get a current location on map. So Android allows us to integrate a Google Map in our application. For this, Google provides us a library via Google Play services for using a map. In order to use the Google Map API, you must register your application on the Google Developer Console and enable the API. So we need to go on the Google Developer Console and we need to take a Google Maps API key so that in the output we can see a Google Map which is of Google. Okay, so to use the Google Map from the Google server, we need to get a Google Maps API key. So with the use of Google Maps API key, we can see an output like a Google Map. Okay, so for seeing a Google Map in the output, we need to take a Google Maps API key from Google Developer Console. So the first steps for getting the Google Maps API key. So why we are taking the API key? API key is only available on Google Developer Console. Okay, and to get a API key from the Google Developer Console, we need to follow these steps. So why we are taking a API key? To see the Google Map in our output. By using its API key only we can see the Google Map in our output. To use a Google Map in our output, we need to take a Google Maps API key from the Google Developer Console. So the first step is an API key is needed to access the Google Maps server. This key is free and you can use it with any of your application. If you haven't created a project, you can follow the steps below to get it started. So the step one is open Google Developer Console. So we need to open a Google Developer Console. So go to the Google Chrome or any browser you are using. Sign in with your Gmail account. We need to sign in with the Gmail account by going in the developer console. So for using a Google developer console, we need to sign in with the Gmail account so that we can use the Google's developer console. Okay. So first of all, go to the browser, any browser you are using. So first of all, we need to go Google Developer Console. So by using this key, or simply you can type a Google Developer Console in your Google, this link, and then or simply you can type a Google Developer Console. This is Google's cloud platform. So sign in with any of your account. So the Google Cloud's platform will be open. Okay, so now here we need to create a project. Okay, so the step you can see here. Now create a new project. You can create a new project by clicking on create project button. So we need to press on create project button. Okay, so press on a create project button. Now any name you can give, I'm using this name only. Press on a create. Now here your project will be created. Project is created now. Now the next step is step 3. Click on API and services and open a dashboard from it. So we need to go on APIs and services and open a dashboard from it. So that dashboard of your project will be open. Now this is the dashboard of your project. Now the next step is in this open enable API and services. So go to the enable APIs and services here. So that this will become. Now we want a Google Maps API key, right? So the next step is now open Google Map Android API. So this is the Google Map Android Maps for SDK for Android. This we need to select. Now here this will become. Now the next step is now enable the Google Map Android API and go to the credentials. So enable it. It will take few minutes. Now this window will become. Now here open a credentials, go to the credentials so that it will be credentials will become all the credentials. Okay, this credentials will become. Now the next, here click on create credentials and choose the API key. So go to the create credentials button and choose the API key. So it is showing you a message, create API key, and this API key will be created. Okay, so the API key will be created. You need to copy that API key from here. You can copy that, okay, and store it somewhere in the notepad. Now your API key will be generated. Copy it and save it somewhere as you will need to use for Google Map in your project. So you need to save the Google Maps API key somewhere, which is created here. Okay, and this API key is created. Now just go to the project where create a new project. So go to the project. Now how it will be started? First of all, go to the file. And you need to take a Google Map. Okay, Google Map. So go to the new project. So the new projects window will become. Now from here, we need to take a not empty activity, we need to take a Google Maps activity. Okay, this is the different. This is difference. Every time we take empty activity, but here we need to take a Google Maps activity and press on the next button so that your project will be loaded. Okay, so Google Maps activity you need to take. Now here I have already taken here. Now the next step is Google Maps API XML. Okay, you need to go to the Google Maps API XML. This is the Google Maps API XML file, which is located in the values folder. Okay, which is located in the values folder. Here in the values folder, Google Maps API XML. This is not a simple XML design file. This is a Google Maps API XML, which is in the values folder. So from that folder, you can open it. And here in this location, you need to enter a Google Map API key, which we have copied from here. we have copied it from here and you need to paste it here, okay, here beside the false. You need to paste it, that whole API key which you have saved it somewhere, and paste it here, okay. So this is in the Google Maps API XML. Now the next is here, enter your Google Map API key. See, this is the same file, Google Maps API XML, this file, and here it will show you your key here. So you need to paste it here, okay. Now the next step is go to the activitymaps.xml file, which is the design file of your project. So activitymaps. That is mapsactivity.java, which is always in the layout folder, design file. Mapsactivity.java. Sorry, maps. It is not a mapsactivity.java. It's a activitymaps.xml. That is a design file, right? That is a design file. So in this file, this is the design file. Here we don't need to make any changes because we are not designing anything. So this is the code in that file. This code will remain same. This is the file. If you open it, then this is the default code here. We don't need to make any changes here. This will remain same. Okay. Now the next is we need to set the permission in the manifest file, okay, for the Google Map. So Android manifest.xml, manifest file is here, and here you need to mention three permissions: access course location, find location, and internet. Internet is to check whether you are connected to internet, and course and find location is for finding a location. So these three permissions you need to mention in the manifest file, okay. Now the next step is we need to make changes in the mapsactivity.java. So our question was to find the current location. So this is the default code which will come with the mapsactivity.java. Just we need to make changes here. Here there are two classes imported, Google Map and Activity Maps Binding. This will be by default come. You don't need to type it. This whole code will be by default come. Okay, don't need to type it. Just we need to make changes here. So here in the onMapReady method, we need to pass a object, okay. So in the onMapReady method, we need to pass a object. So object of Google Map. This is the Google Map, and we need to pass a object here. And the next is the lat-lang position. So as we know, lat-lang is a latitude and longitude which we have studied in the lecture. So we need to press a lat-long position. Latitude is east-west position, and longitude is north and south position of your location, right? So you need to find out the current location. So we need to mention a current location here. Okay, so here we need to mention a current location, latitude. This is a latitude point, and this is a longitude point. Okay, from where you will take it? From the Google Map, you can take the latitude and longitude point. Okay, so if you need to go to the Google Map and get your current location, go to the Google Map and get your current location. Where you have located, you need to take the current location. It can be anything. Get your current location. Whole Google Map will be located. So you can take your current location. If I want the current location of this primary health, so or anything, then you need to right click on it. Just right click on it and take latitude and longitude point from here. Okay, so press it here. So it will show you the current location. Whatever points you have mentioned in this, in the output, that location will be shown. Okay, add marker to the position, so it will add the marker. Like for example, you can see the output. Whatever point or location point you have mentioned, it will add the marker. This is the output. It will add a marker here. It will add a marker here, and it will show you my current location. Okay. So it will add a marker. It will add marker by using this add marker method and move the camera according to where you zoom in, zoom out, that like that. And add marker, and it will show you whatever message you have typed in this. So I have typed my current location. So it will tell you my current location on that marker. Okay. So this is the Google Maps program. By using latlang, it will show you the latitude and longitude point. And I show you the method how to find out the latitude and longitude point of your location. Okay. Right clicking on it. So it right click on the location description. So it will show you latitude and longitude point of your location. So this is the Google Map program to show you the current location. Okay. This is the only code we need to change in the mapsactivity.java. This code is already there. Just you need to mention your coordinates. Okay, just you need to mention your coordinates there. Here you need to mention your coordinates. Okay. So this is the Google Maps program. So from this, all the practicals are completed of mobile application development. Thank you.